Okay, we have our very first caller. His name is Vrax. He's from Quezon City. So, hello Vrax, welcome to the show.
Hi, Vince. Thank you for taking my call. Just want to ask a question or your take on your opinion on what's your opinion on having to financially support your family and as well as extended family, even though you're married and have also a child on that, because that's a, you know, that's a common thing right now. Even though you're married to someone, of course you are also married to her family as well. So that cannot be helped. So I'm just wondering what's your take on that.
So you're saying, ano yung take or opinion ko about sa pagsusupport or siguro support financially sa extended family or relative, tama?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Actually, meron akong kilala personally na ginagawa nun, gumagawa nun. Kasi, syempre tayo, Filipino tayo eh. I mean, it's part of our culture. Unlike dito sa US, dito, pag tungtong ng 18 years old nung, kunyari, nung bata, wala na, kanya-kanyang buhay na yan. Pero sa atin sa Pilipinas, hanggat nakatira ka sa pamamahay, actually, or hanggat sa kinasal ka na, tutulong ka at tutulong ka, whether it's financial, emotional, spiritual. Actually, yun, lahat yun. Well, I think it's part of our culture. Gaya ko ngayon, tumutulong pa rin ako sa, yun nga, sa parents ko. Well, if you're asking about the extended family, siguro, for me, merong limitation. If it's emergency, kapag siguro, ano, for health reasons, why not help, right?
No, won't there be any conflict between you and your spouse about it?
Ah, good question.
And how do you talk things over with these kinds of issues or, you know, them asking help from you?
Okay, good question. Actually, syempre, since mag-asawa na kayo, since you guys are married, mas maganda you guys talk about it first. Kasi syempre, kung kunwari pera yung kailangan na tulong, syempre, hindi lang naman ikaw yung mag-decide dapat niyan eh. Dapat yung kayong dalawa ng spouse mo. Kasi syempre, I mean, pera yung dalawa yun eh. Hindi naman pwedeng ikaw lang yung magde-decide. Ayun, siguro going back to dun sa question nga na helping your extended family, ano na natin, specific example is financial. Kasi yun naman yung karamihan ng tulong na kailangan ng relatives, di ba? So, yun lang yung take ko. Na merong limitations. Kapag, ako, personally, kapag health reasons, pag emergency, okay lang. Pero wag naman umabot doon sa point na wala ka nang matitira. Kasi syempre, paano kung may anak ka na? May anak ka na ba, Vrax? Syempre, hindi ko pa alam.
Yeah.
Yun. So, syempre, isipin mo rin yung future nung, or yung current needs nyo nung wife mo and nung anak mo. Kasi kung ibibigay mo naman lahat, hindi rin naman tama yun. Dapat isipin mo rin yung current status nyo. I mean, there's nothing wrong in helping a relative. Mas okay nga yun. Pero ayun, basta yun. Yun lang yung gusto na sabi ko. Meron ka pa ba ibang tanong for today, Vrax? Or
No, that would be all. Thanks, Vince. Thanks for your advice. And I hope your show continues on in helping people.
Yes. Siyempre kasi ikaw yung first caller. At sana maging mag-turn out to ng okay. At yun lang. And paano ba? Sige.
Thanks. Yes, thanks. Thank you.
Alright, thanks, Vrax.
So, in addition to the things that I've said sa mga pinagsasabi ko kanina, this topic is not new to me or to the Filipino people. Kasi tayong mga Pilipino, our culture is, I mean, meron tayong strong family ties. Hindi ko naman sinasabing yung mga taga rito sa Amerika, hindi sila ganun. Pero, that's just my observation tayo. Kahit hanggang sa mga extended family, extended relatives natin, tinutulungan natin sila. Sobrang close natin. There's nothing wrong in helping a relative financially or any other aspect. So thank you, Vrax, for calling. You are actually the first caller. So now for the other viewers, if you wanna be part of the show, send me a message on Instagram. We will schedule a call. So I am looking forward to speaking to you guys. So if you have questions or problems about life or love life, family, career, ano ba? Anything under the sun, just message me on Instagram. We will set up a call or schedule a call. Thank you so much for watching. Please like my Facebook page and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And see you next time. Bye-bye.
I got some dirty shit to pick up at the dry cleaner. I got a tidy bitch to pick up, I got less Selena. Shady hop up in the whip, but I ain't never seen it. Shady love the way I whip it in a two-seater.